morning to everyone. Today we are here to complete the remaining question of chapter 8. Last day we have done up to question number 4. Today we will start with question number 5. Question number 5 is, let's start writing. All of you get ready with your notebook, pen, and let's start the work. Question number 5 is, why are the chains of states temporary? Temporary, and the answer for this question is because heating and cooling reverses the chains. Because heating and cooling reverses the chains. Now let's write question number 6. What do you understand? What do you understand? Either you have to pause the video or take the screenshot and complete it. Question number 6 is, what do you understand by the terms expansion and contraction? Answer is, the increase in size of matter on heating is called expansion. The decrease in size of matter on cooling is called contraction. This is question number 6. We have completed chapter 8. I hope all of you have written it. I am getting aside from the board. You can take this screenshot or you can pause the video and write it. Okay. Now, we will start chapter 9 without wasting any time. After writing, my dear students, you close your notebook, open your textbook, chapter number 9, and get ready for studying. Now, you did not write anything. Just open the book and look into the book and in the mobile, and what you have to do? You have to understand chapter 9. I'm going to teach you chapter 9. Force, work, and energy. Force, work, and energy. This is the meaning of the chapter 9. Force, work, and energy. Simply we talk about it. We talk about the word force. In simple language, we say that push or pull is called the force. Pushing anything or pulling anything is called the force. Different examples are given in the book. Let's study about that. Kicking a ball, opening a door, pulling a cart, pushing a box, lifting a bag, all these actions are resulting in the change of position of an object. Suppose if chalk is kept here and if I want to keep it onto the other place, what I am doing? I am applying a force and changing its position from one place to other place. And this is what called the force. Each of these activities involves the effort of push or pull. If I have to take this chalk, what I am doing? I am lifting it. A push or pull that changes the state of motion of an object is called a force. This is the term push or pull which changes the states of motion of an object is called a force. Force gives energy to move, stop or change direction. Suppose if I am walking this way and if someone comes from back and pushes me, what I will do? What will happen with me? I will just fall. So this is changing position of my body and this is what called force. We cannot see force, but we know that it's there because we can observe its effects. We cannot see actually what is force, but we can see its actions. We can see the result of the force, and about that we will study the next topic. Next topic is effects of force. Effects of force. A force can make a stationary object move. If I am standing here quietly and talking to you, teaching to you, someone comes and pushes to me, I will change my position. I will start moving. So this can make a stationary object move and can change the shape and size of an object. Chalk is in this way. If I break it, now what happens? Its size is changed. And if I crush it, now it is in powdered shape. So shape is also changed. Okay? So this can change the shape and size of an object. If force can stop movement or make a moving object, change its speed. Suppose if I am walking slowly and someone pushes me, I will start moving fast. So my speed will change. If force can change the direction in which an object is moving, if I am moving in this direction, someone comes and turns my face like this, I will start moving in this direction. So what force can do? Force can change the direction of an object. We must remember that none of these actions which we discussed now is possible without the
without applying the force or without absence of the force.
Force is needed to do all these actions. What activity is given in your book?
Here it's told that play cricket with a friend. Every time the ball is thrown to you, what you do?
You hit in different directions. This direction, this direction, this direction, up, back, every direction.
You will notice that you are able to change the speed and direction of the ball. You can kick this side, you can do this side, then back side. How?
Because by applying the force.
Hence, it can be said that force is being applied to the ball and due to the force, it moves it. Clear? Understood, everyone?
Now, we will study about the types of force.
There are different types of forces that act in different ways. And first one is gravitational force.
Gravitational forces.
Gravity is the force of attraction which pulls things to the earth.
What is gravity from this word, gravitational forces? One word comes, gravity. So first let's understand the meaning of the word gravity.
Gravity is the force of attraction which pulls things to the earth. If I throw this chalk upward, what will happen? It will come downwards. It will go to a certain height, then it will start falling down. Do we stay in the air or come down after jumping? If we jump, do we stay in the air?
No, this doesn't happen. We come down.
Suppose if I am jumping like this, I will come down.
Yes,
certainly I will come down. Because there is gravity on the earth and it pulls the things to the earth. There is an invisible force that keeps everything bound to the earth. And the force with which objects pull one another is called the gravitational forces. The force with which object pulls one another.
Sir Isaac Newton was the first to discover this, the law of gravity. Who was the first to discover the law of gravity? Sir Isaac Newton was the first who discovered the law of gravity.
He was sitting under an apple tree. His theory was that every object attracts another object towards it using a force called gravity. Gravity acts between everything in the universe. All the planets, including the Earth, are held in their orbit or in their position around the sun because of gravity. We know that all the planets are held in their position. And why they are held in their position around the sun? Due to gravity. Clear?
This is about the gravitational force. This is the first type of force. Now we will study about different other type of forces. Second one is the magnetic force. times I have caught your magnet which you are bringing in the school, no? Some materials are capable of exerting a special kind of force. And that special kind of force is nothing but the magnetic force. That special kind of force is nothing but the magnetic force. A magnet attracts or pulls certain things made up of iron, cobalt, and nickel towards itself. The things which are made up of iron, nickel, then cobalt, these are attracted towards the magnet. These are attracted towards the magnet. The force applied by the magnet on an object is called the magnetic force. What is magnetic force? The force applied by an object on the magnet is called the magnetic force. The force applied by magnet on an object. The force is being applied by magnet on the object, and that is called the magnetic force. Some powerful electromagnets are used to lift very heavy objects in workshops. Some iron pieces sticking to another iron object can be removed by the magnet. Suppose some other materials which we do not want are attracted on another magnet. Iron pieces, we can remove it by magnet. In factories, iron is separated from the scrap by electromagnets. With the help of electromagnets, in the factories, they separate the iron pieces. Now, we will study about the another type of force, that is electrostatic force. Electrostatic force. Let's see what is this. Electrostatic force. The force exerted by a charged body on another charged or uncharged body is called the electrostatic force. Once again I will tell, the force exerted by a charged body on another charged or uncharged body is called the electrostatic force. One example I will give. Take the comb and rub it vigorously on your hair. What will happen? After rubbing it, what you need to do? Then bring it close to the balloon. Balloon, you know, no? Or the small pieces of papers. The balloon or the small pieces of paper will get attracted towards the comb. Why this happens? This comb gets charged due to the friction. Friction means rubbing. And the force that attracts the paper and ball balloon towards the comb is called the electrostatic force. That is called the electrostatic force. By rubbing the comb, it gets charged and it starts attracting the balloon or comb towards itself. Electric air purifiers used in chimneys make use of this force. What is it? If anyone asks you, what is use of this electrostatic force? Electric air purifiers which are used in chimneys make use of this electrostatic force. Clear to everyone? Now, let's study about the next type of force, frictional force. Frictional force. Frictional force. The force that opposes the motion of an object and tries to stop or slow it down is called the frictional force. The force that opposes the motion of an object and tries to stop or slow it down is called the frictional force. Example, a child plays with a toy car, pushes it forward. It goes up to a certain distance and then what happens? It stops itself. Why it stops? Because the friction between the floor and friction between the floor and the wheel of car, this toy car stops. And with the force of friction is less on the smooth surface. On the smooth surface, the friction is less. Friction is less. And on the rough surface, the friction is more. On the rough surface, friction is more. For example, push a box over a smooth surface, we can see that it's easier to push on it on smooth surface because the force of friction is less on the smooth surface than on a rough surface. In our daily life, it's not possible to do certain activities in the absence of friction, means force of friction is necessary. In next class, we will study in detail about the force of friction and different ways to reduce the friction. For today, this much is enough. Revise it and tomorrow we will meet again. Thank you, class.